Hey guys, Jake with 8020 Media here. Today we're going to be talking about signs and symptoms of a bad fuel filter. Anytime you have a fueling related problem, the first thing to check, and probably the easiest or least expensive thing, is going to be this fuel filter. The fuel filter is similar to an air filter or an oil filter, and the whole purpose of it is for it to catch any dirt, debris, or particulates that might be floating through your fuel system to prevent them from being sent to the injectors and into the engine. So naturally, as with any filter, over time it can get clogged up and gunked up with dirt and debris, and what that can do is then restrict fuel flow. As it restricts fuel flow, you'll lead to a number of fueling related issues as well as performance related issues. So in this guide, we're gonna go ahead and talk about all of the signs and symptoms that you might get when you have a bad fuel filter. And then I'll talk a little bit about how to diagnose whether it's bad or not, how to test the fuel filter, and what you need to do to replace it. So the fuel filter usually sits somewhere in between the fuel injectors and the fuel lines. On some vehicles, it can be difficult to get to, and some vehicles make it extremely simple. But the good news is these fuel filters are only about $10 or $15, so they are cheap to replace. It's just whether or not it's easy and accessible on your vehicle or easy enough for you to be able to do it from home. But first, let's go ahead and talk about some of the signs and symptoms that your fuel filter is the problem that's causing whatever it is that's going on with your vehicle. So a couple things that you might notice is hard starts, rough idling, engine stalling, cylinder misfires, poor performance or a lack of acceleration, decreased fuel pressure, and lean air-to-fuel ratios. You're not always going to get an engine code when your fuel filter is bad, and that's because there is nothing that would tell you that the fuel filter is clogged up. There are no sensors that are attached to this or no way to tell what the inside of this looks like, so you might not get any engine codes, but if you do get engine codes, you're probably going to get some pretty generic engine codes like a P0171 for your AFRs running a little bit too lean or a little bit too rich. Having a fueling related engine code related to your air to fuel ratios can be a good sign that you have an issue with your fuel filter, but it could also let you know that you have an issue with any one of your other fueling components. So as we think about a fuel filter and what happens when it goes bad, it basically gets clogged and then it restricts fuel flow. And so it can lead to a ton of problems if your engine's not getting enough fuel as it needs. You can have a lot of acceleration issues. Your car could run fine at idle because the fuel filter is not clogged up enough to restrict it at idle. But then as you start to accelerate or once you reach a certain RPM or a certain speed, your engine either becomes very sluggish or it stalls. And that's because the fuel filter is restricting the fuel from getting to the engine, which can then starve the engine of fuel and cause it to struggle to accelerate or to stall out. The biggest problem with diagnosing the fuel filter is that list of signs and symptoms that I just told you is extremely generic. You can have all of those issues if there's something wrong with any other component of your fueling system. If you've got bad spark plugs or bad ignition coils or have something that's wrong with the ignition side of your engine. So it becomes extremely difficult to diagnose specifically a fuel filter because there is nothing that tells you that it is the fuel filter. The first step is really to determine, first of all, that you have a fueling issue and not an issue with ignition or some other component on the engine. So if your engine's not starting at all, it's not going to be the fuel filter. You're going to notice hard starts, rough idling, and maybe stalling at higher RPMs if you have a clogged up fuel filter. But if your vehicle's not starting at all, it's not going to be the fuel filter unless this thing is just so clogged up that no fuel can get past it at all. So once we decide that it is a fueling problem and it's not spark plugs or ignition coils or a camshaft position sensor, then we can start ticking through, okay, what else could it be within the fueling system? And so there's a couple other common things that tend to go bad fueling related, and that's your fuel injectors, your fuel pump, or your fuel pressure regulator. Out of all of those components, the easiest thing to test and to tell if it's bad or to replace is going to be the fuel filter. These fuel filters, like I said, are only $10 or $15, whereas a fuel pump is probably $200, $300, or even $400, and fuel injectors are very expensive too. And so the two simplest things are gonna be the fuel filter as well as the fuel pressure regulator. Now, diagnosing which one it is a little bit difficult. The only way to really test a fuel filter requires you to actually pull the fuel filter off of the vehicle. And one thing that you can do is go ahead and put like a straw in here, and then you blow through it with a straw to try to see how much resistance there is within the fuel filter. If you can blow through it easily, then the fuel filter is not gunked up or clogged up. And if there's resistance to it, then that means that it could be dirty inside and need to be replaced. The only problem with doing a test like that is if you've never done that before, you have no clue how much resistance there is supposed to be within the fuel filter. And second of all, you have to pull the fuel filter off first. In my opinion, if you're gonna have to pull the fuel filter already, you might as well just replace it, because it's 10 or 15 bucks. And especially if you don't take your car to the dealership for standard 60 or 90,000 mile maintenance, you're probably not gonna have ever changed the fuel filter on your vehicle before. There is a chance that even if your fuel filter is not that dirty, it probably isn't super clean either. And so if your fuel filter hasn't been replaced ever or anytime recently, just replace it. So there isn't a whole lot to pinpoint you specifically on like diagnostic steps to take to test the fuel filter. The first step always is to read your engine codes and see what engine codes you might have and to see where that might lead you. Go ahead and do a Google search of what engine codes you have as well as your vehicle, and you'll likely find someone who's experienced this problem before. So ultimately, it's very difficult to diagnose. My honest opinion on it is just go ahead and replace it anyways. If it hasn't been replaced in a long time, it probably needs to be replaced. Your engine will run a lot better for it. You might even notice some increases in your fuel economy. It's good to just go ahead and replace it if yours is easy to access and to eliminate this as a potential problem on your list. If you have problems and engine codes after changing this, then you're gonna wanna start looking at your fuel pump, your fuel pressure regulator, as well as your injectors and all the other fueling components that can cause fueling related problems. Now, one question is, how frequently should you replace these things? I would recommend on older engines that you replace them every 30 to 60,000 miles, especially on older vehicles, just since your older car is likely to have more dirt, gunk, and debris within its gas tank. On newer vehicles, probably every 60 to 90,000 miles. And then on diesel vehicles specifically, diesel fuel filters should be changed every 10 to 15,000 miles. And that's just because of how much dirtier diesel fuel is than traditional gasoline, just from the natural refinement process of it, since diesel is less refined than gasoline is. Anyways, guys, I hope this is helpful as you try to diagnose what fueling issues you're having. If you have any questions or if I can help with any diagnostics, go ahead and drop a comment below. I do my best to respond to every comment that gets posted on there. And if you appreciate this video, please click the like button, subscribe to our channel, and stay tuned for our future content.